Hey, I'm Dr. McCleary, and in this video, we're gonna talk about feelings.
Feelings? Yay! Feelings? Oh no.
Hey, I'm Dr. Harry McCleary, and I'm a licensed clinical psychologist and Navy veteran. And I spend the majority of my week treating active duty service members with PTSD. In this video, we're gonna talk about, you guessed it, feelings. And not just what feelings are, but what purpose do they actually serve? I'm going to start with an emotion that we're all very familiar with, anger. So we're all familiar with anger, but what actual purpose does it serve? I look at anger as kind of an alert system that something's going on and we need to react to something immediately. Sometimes anger alerts us that we're being disrespected. Sometimes anger alerts us that we're unsafe in some way. Sometimes anger alerts us that maybe someone is questioning our own self-worth. Maybe someone is trying to take their love away. There are many ways in why people get angry, but they all kind of serve the same purpose. They're alerting you that something about your life, something about you, something about someone else is off. And for many of us, we have that urge to immediately fix it, and not always in the best way. Throughout life, many of us are bombarded with a lot of information about which emotions are okay to have, which emotions you shouldn't have, which emotions are useless, which emotions are okay to express. For a lot of men, for a lot of veterans, for a lot of people still serving in uniform, anger is the one emotion that, so go ahead and express that. That can become problematic. And let me explain why. Anger is one emotion, but we have multiple emotions. However, if we only feel comfortable expressing anger, the rest of our emotions are going to come across as, guess what? Angry. And this becomes an issue when you need someone to respond to one of those other emotions, anxiety, fear, sadness, joy. However, what they see is anger, and thus they respond to that. The next emotion that I want to talk about is fear. And fear is another one of those alarm systems that goes off. And the purpose of fear is to alert us that something is going on. Something about our environment is unsafe. So fear is really there to keep us safe. The tricky thing about fear is, with some individuals, they're told to not be afraid of anything. Well, not being afraid of anything in itself is problematic. And it's problematic because of this. If you are in a situation that is inherently dangerous and you don't feel some of that fear, you might put yourself in those types of situations more often than you need to be in them. And that becomes extremely problematic. And this is where being numb to feelings can actually put you in more danger than actually feeling those feelings. An instructor in the military once told me, hey, there's a difference between being brave and being stupid. And right there, you were stupid. The next emotion that I want to talk about is anxiety. And anxiety, kind of like fear, gets us moving. When we start to feel anxiety, we start to feel like, oh, well, we have to do something about this. We need to run. We are getting motivated to make some changes. That's why anxiety is actually very important. Think about anxiety as your own internal hourglass. So it's not until we find something or something in our environment that we feel like, oh, well, I have to react. I not only have so much time to react to it. Now we start to feel that anxiety of, okay, well, time is ticking. Anxiety can obviously be overwhelming, and I know that a lot of people struggle with that. However, anxiety also is our own internal motivator that gets us going. So anxiety, just like fear and anger, serves a purpose. So let's lighten it up a little bit. Let's talk about joy. Let's talk about happiness. And I say lighten it up on purpose because that's kind of what joy and happiness sometimes feel like. Feels like, oh, you're just kind of floating. You feel lighter. You feel like things are good. Happiness, joy, are those feel-good emotions, but they're also tricky. And I say they're tricky because when things are going good, often people don't feel the same types of alerts, so they don't actually keep track of what is actually making them happy, what is actually causing that joy. And this is where people can go wrong. I want to encourage people to stop and think about what actually brings them joy, what actually makes them happy. Dare I say, what do you actually like? Many of us fall into a life in which we get into a routine to where we do things over and over again, and none of those things are really bringing us happiness or joy. They may be bringing someone else happiness or joy, and that might be nice, but we have forgotten about, or maybe we don't even know, what brings us joy and happiness. I want you to take a little bit of time to think about that, because happiness and joy also have alerts, but because they feel good, it's easy to forget about those things and not think about them until we really need them. The last emotion that I want to talk about is sadness. I may have a biased opinion here, being a psychologist, but there's a great movie called Inside Out that explains all of these emotions. And yes, it is in a kid format, but I enjoyed it. Sadness is a really important emotion, but at the same time, it's one that none of us really want to feel. And the purpose of sadness is to facilitate a grieving process. And we all go through multiple losses throughout life. Whether it's the loss of a loved one, whether it's the loss of an opportunity, maybe it's just a loss of your wallet that you need to go out and get something. Grieving something is a very natural and a healthy process. And sadness is the emotion that drives that process. I hear some of you saying, well, why would I want to grieve? Well, grieving is a healing process. And in order to really get over a loss, that grieving process needs to take place. Where this can get complicated for many people is when their loss is traumatic or their loss is all of a sudden. The last thing that we want to do is think about it. Last thing that we want to do is feel some of those hard emotions that are attached to that loss. So what we do is we don't look at it. What we do is we try to block it out. We don't think about it. Well, what this does is it just elongates that grieving process. If you need evidence of this, think about a person that something happened to them long time ago. They had a loss long time ago. but they refuse to talk about it. They act like it never happened. But for them, it still feels like it happened yesterday. And that is why sadness is so important. Why feeling sadness is so important. So it can take you through that grieving process so you can heal. So you can see the other side. Because if you just avoid it, really what you're doing at the same time of as stopping that fear, that sadness in the moment, you're also blocking that grieving process from happening. So anger, fear, anxiety, joy, sadness. Five emotions. And I recognize there are many more emotions that I could talk about, but I don't want to overwhelm you. I also recognize that people can struggle with one of these emotions, all of these emotions, or struggle with feeling any of these emotions. I recognize that. But the first step in tackling any one of those emotions or all of those emotions is understanding what those emotions actually are and what purpose they serve. Something to think about. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel. But more important than that, if you know a veteran that would benefit from watching this video, I ask that you share it with them. Because at the end of the day, that's really what all of this is about. One veteran trying to help another. Thank you.